Today on the Sonic Experience, I'm showing you how to decode a raw mid-side microphone recording. A raw mid-side recording is different than a regular stereo mid-side recording in that the mid-mic, which faced the center, will run through your left channel, and the side mic, which faced left and right, is summed to one signal and will run through your right channel. Why would you want to do this? To keep the mid and side separate. In a regular stereo mid-side recording, the left and right channels are different, but the mid mic is evenly mixed into the left and right channels, and you can't process it separately from the sides after that. And you won't be able to take advantage of this super easy, super powerful technique that allows you to produce a really wide stereo image. And there's really nothing to this, guys. It's a lot more straightforward than it might sound. So, okay, let's dive right in. I know of two different ways you can go about this. You can use a decoder plugin, or you can simulate what the plugin does yourself using some basic DAW functions. First, I'll show you with the plugin. Okay, locate your raw mid-side file and drag it into the project. Oh, and shout out to my buddy Aaron, who was kind enough to play drums for us for this demo. Okay, when you play it back raw, you should be able to tell that the center is on the left and the sides are on the right. The signal level of the mid channel will be higher than the side channel if it was directly facing the sound source. See, it sounds pretty wacky. So to decode this with a plugin, just insert the plugin. So what's it done here? It put the center back in the center. It split the side signal into two signals and hard panned them left and right, and flipped the phase of the right. It's the inversion of the phase on one side that's important here, guys. That's what gives it the wide sound. The sides should be 180 degrees out of phase, and if played back in mono, should completely cancel each other out. Now you can adjust the balance between the mid and sides for the ideal width. But my preferred way of going about this is just to simulate what the plugin does yourself, while having the center, left, and right on completely separate mono tracks for even more control. Just locate your raw mid-side file, right-click, and split it into mono tracks. Now this left one's your center, and this right one's your side. Drag them into the project. This one's the center. Always good to name your tracks so you don't get confused later. Now duplicate the side track. This one's left. And this one's right. Hard pan them. Now put a plug-in with a phase switch on the right side and invert the phase. Studio One has this mix tool plugin. Now you can adjust the stereo width and process the center, left, and right all separate from each other. This is a very powerful technique and is really common for drum room miking, like we did in this example. Obviously, this wouldn't be your whole drum sound, but if you blend it in with your close mics and overheads, you should have a nice big sound. Alright guys, if that helped, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.